Greetings, family. Greetings, my friends. I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Our family, I want to share this with you. I want to explain to you. I want to tell you what happened. What do we learn from this? Family, I always tell you, God speaks to each one of us. Just that sometimes we pretend, sometimes you don't listen, sometimes you're like busy, you pretend to be busy, you know. Sometimes you're like, there's something that is stopping you to listen to God's word. There's something that is there, there is always a wall. Not so. God's speaking to you, and you are taking what God is telling you. They are different. God speaks to you, but you take what God tells you. Sometimes you're like, God tells you to do this, you're like, I don't think this is right, and, you know, because there is something that is stopping you to get this God's communication. There is something stopping you. Not so. But family, so I will give you Bible verses about counseling, advising others, or seeking advice. Family, I was in the village, and in this dream, I will tell you what happened. In this dream, I saw my uncle. It's called Uncle Msinguzi, elder, a brother of my mother. Is the elder brother Uncle Msinguzi. We are in the village, and was like, you know, Junior, he spoke to me. He had that idea. He wanted to sell. Was going to sell his land. In that land, that's why he owns his house. And his family is there. He has it's a huge land, a piece of land, you know. I don't know the acres, but it's huge. And it's like there is farming there. I know there are some activities doing there, banana what. There are so many activities. They are rearing. So I spoke to him. I was like, what's the reason? He told me, you know, I want money for school fees for my kids. I was like, you're selling because you want money for school fees for your kids? I was like, I don't think that's the best idea. That's the right option you're doing. I told him, it's like, you know, you're like, you have another land somewhere. I think you can get a piece of that, or you can just get a piece, maybe, and sell it, or give it to someone, maybe to do their farming, maybe that will pay you that money. At least you invest more in this farming of yours and this rearing of yours, rearing of animals, not so. That's what I spoke. You know, this rearing and farming, it's like this business, let this business boost, you boost this business, you know, like it will help you, it will be helping you, source of it will be a source of income, you know. But I told her, I told him that, Uncle, you know, saying that you're going to sell your area, you'll sell your area, you end up selling all your things, and you and even you may not end up, you may end up not even paying fees for all these kids, not even these kids completing their education. So the kids will be stuck from somewhere, and still you don't have where to stay, like all the things are destroyed. Not so. I told him, no, that's not the right idea. You take the other advice I've given you. Yes, get the other land. You have some land somewhere, sell a little, then add in this business, then it will help you. You know, to help make sure that you concentrate on this business. And I think then surprisingly there are other people who are claiming to advise him, yet they are like, maybe they wanted to destroy his plan. They were telling him, you sell, yeah, we saw that coming, you sell, you have to educate your children, at least you sell, you rather sell everything, you know. But when we came to find out, these are the same people who were like, they wanted to buy this area. They were like, yeah, we've got this opportunity, let us destroy him and let us buy this land, you know. Imagine, where is the world heading to? You're letting someone fall into a ditch, and you're like, maybe you're advising, you're pretending to advise him or her, you know. Yet you're like, we are destroyed, let us destroy him. Family, that is not right. Family, what we learn from this dream is like, seeking advice is good, but always, that's why I always tell you, you must walk with God, so that you must know, is this advice good, or is it a fake advice, or it's just going to throw me into a pit, you know. It's like, family, another thing is, unless maybe someone is completing maybe his education, and maybe the final year is like, when he misses, or if she misses, then again she has to wait for another year. Yet this was just the final exams, and maybe in institute you're like, at least she's completing, then you can get a piece and maybe help him this somewhat, because you know, after he gets out, he'll be able to get a job, and maybe he'll be also helping you. not well, I think someone that is someone can understand, but you're selling your land because of the kids will be there. Just some kids are in primary doing what you just said. You'll end up selling your land, and even these kids will not complete, even these children will not complete the education. So you're losing all. You're losing your land, you're losing your area, your kids are not completing. So what do you benefit? And another thing is family. If maybe you know your status, your income status, and like maybe some of your children are like maybe S4 or S1, you can take these children. First of all, let them learn what you're doing. Another thing is, you can branch them maybe to an institution. In that institution, they can start studying while they are being educated, when they are even being paid. Some institutions do that. So get the best plan. Not so. Get the best plan to help your family. Family, let us look forward. Not so. Let us look forward. That will help us, family, for the future and for the generation. Not so. Family, let me give you Bible verses about counseling or advising others. Then I'll explain as I conclude. Family, go and read, or seeking advice also. Family, go and read Proverbs chapter 11, verse 14. Go and read Proverbs chapter 15, verse 22. Go and read Proverbs chapter 13, verse 10. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 6. Proverbs chapter 20, verse 18. Psalms chapter 16, verse 7 to 8. Psalms chapter 32, verse 8. James chapter 3, verse 17. John chapter 16, verse 13. John chapter 14, verse 26. Proverbs chapter 19, verse 20. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 15. Family, here you see the word of God saying, nations fall due to lack of guidance. Amen. Plans fail without advice. Amen. Wisdom is in who takes advice. Amen. Wisdom comes with many counselors. Amen. I will praise the Lord who counsels me. This I told you is the counselor of all counselors. Stubborn fool considers his own way the right one. Yes, you don't want to seek advice. Stubborn people, they are like, they pretend to know everything. They know everything. This is what they do. But a person who listens to advice is wise. Amen. Family, like I've told you here above, I praise the Lord of, yes, the Lord is, that's why I'm telling you, walk with the Lord. You'll be able to know. Walk with the Lord. You know, let Jesus be in you. Not so. You'll be able to differentiate that this one maybe is guiding me, is running me astray, or it's guiding me. I'm on the right track. Not so. Family, it will help you. Not so. But like what we're telling him, I cancel that in Jesus' name. That's a wrong attitude. No believer can do that. You're letting someone fall into a ditch because you wish you can have what he has or what she has, and you're letting her fall into a shit or into a ditch. No, it's not advisable for the believers. Others can do it, but the believers you cannot do such a thing. We are examples to others, so that we may let them know the truth. And they will join us. I'm on Junior Rukundo Facebook, Rangana Magaragandi Facebook, Kisugu Uganda, Tumanyuno Facebook, the Facebook accounts, Twitter at Amon Junior, Instagram, Amon Junior 1651987. There is a Facebook page for God and Our Heaven, Raj page. Go there, like that page, share those videos, and sharing them, that means you're helping me spread the word of God. Family, there is a Facebook page, God Our Heaven in Jesus' name. Amen. Raj page. That's a Facebook page. Go there. You will see that page there. There's YouTube account, Love Amon Junior or Amon Junior Rukundo. Go there, subscribe, share those videos. Yeah, let us spread the word of God. Family, another thing is, if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your only personal savior, family, what are you waiting for? You're like, I'm not a sinner. I still have time. I'm young. Why should I hurry? And you're like, maybe I'll do them at the same time. I'm still busy. Even I don't have a wife, you know, I still have things to work on. Please, how do you get a wife when you're not in Jesus Christ? How will you be able to succeed in your business when you're not letting Jesus Christ guide you? And by letting Jesus, to let Jesus Christ to guide you, you should be in him and he should be in you. But this is only done when you accept him as your only personal savior. Another thing, you must be baptized. And you're like, and some of you are like, I'm already born again, but for the baptism, I'll do it. After all, I did the other difficult part, the other part. So this is, I'll do also this part. please, it's a journey. It's a journey. There are so many things to be done. You say you're baptized when you're young, you accept Jesus Christ as your own personal savior, you confess, you flee those sins. Then even if you're young, when did you confess? I told you you're born sinners right from the Adam and Eve era. So when did you confess? And for you, you're like, we are young, you know. At least for me, I'm young. I'm not, you know, I'm just 18, I'm just 20, I'm just moving into the world. I haven't seen family. Talk to the pastors, they will guide you, bishops, they will guide you how to do it. Talk to them, don't fear them. Respect them, but don't fear them. That's what I always tell you. They are there to guide us, we are there to learn from them. And what you learn, preach to others, talk to others. That's why I always tell you, you must bear fruits. You must bear fruits. Bearing fruits is not only having children. I always tell you, even spreading the word of God is bearing fruits. Not so. Family, another thing that I've witnessed, I also saw this, what God showed me this, that people, you don't move your Bibles. Family, you're like, some of you are like, we have gadget Bibles, you have my Samsung, there's an application, a Bible. Sometimes you want to read the word and there is no internet. Sometimes there's no power. Sometimes you're like, internet is slow. Sometimes it's like, I thought it's an offline Bible, but no, there's no power, family. You end up waiting for the power maybe to charge. You end up sleeping. You miss that word. You know, you're like, maybe it wasn't God's plan. Who told you? Who told you, my friends? You know what to do. I told you, I always move my Bible. When I was coming, when I was going to Iraq, I was with this Bible. This may not be the same Bible, because sometimes I give Bible to some people. And someone takes it, I tell him, oh, take it, it's okay. Not so, no problem. And then I get another Bible. But when I was in Iraq, I also had my Bible. Sometimes your friends go to vacation, you cannot even tell them, my friend, bring me a Bible. Or you give him money, or her, bring me a Bible. But you're like, bring me such this food. Bring me groundnuts from Africa. Bring me what, bananas from Africa. Please, bring me yams from Africa. What's this? You know? You cannot tell that person, get this money, bring me a Bible. And you're like, I forgot my Bible. Some of you, even when you're going, maybe traveling somewhere, even maybe abroad, like you get your Bible when you're at home, you keep it somewhere. Mommy, keep this Bible for me. When I come, I want to have this Bible. It's like where you're going, there's no worshiping. And you leave your Bible. My God, my God, my God. Okay. I love you so much, family. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. I know you will come slow by slow, you learn. You'll come to know this. God bless you.